In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord,
and of your Spirit.
Good morning.
Morning, Cousin Tom.
We celebrate today with the Holy Church, the feast of St. Clare, contemporary and friend of St. Francis. As we invoke her prayers today, let us remember that we too are called to follow in the footsteps of the saints. Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, help us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to the Father. Christ help us.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of God. Lord, help us.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. The God, who in all mercy led St. Clare to a love of poverty, grant through her intercession, and following her rise in poverty of spirit, we may merit to contemplate you one day in the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
but also inherit eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If you've ever seen the film Brother Sun, Sister Moon, you'll remember how the life of St. Clare is reflected in that film as a contemporary friend of St. Francis in Assisi in the 12th century. It is a lovely, if not romantic, romanticized version of her life, because in reality, her life was very austere and very severe. As we know, as a contemporary St. Francis, she was deeply affected by his court poverty and established her own monastery south of the town of Assisi, a beautiful place where she lived a life of simplicity among the many sisters who came to join her. It was a life of prayer, a life of contemplation, and a deep love of the Eucharist. In one of the stories of her life, she held a remonstrance of the Eucharist enclosed, defending Assisi from attack, a sign of also not just her deep prayer, but her deep courage. And we remember her with the whole church today. St. Clare,
pray for us.
So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers and intercessions. We pray for the church and all of God's holy people. Maybe today on this feast day of St. Clare, we remember all those who still follow him in the poor clerics, giving their lives selflessly in the midst of their isolation and in their convents dedicated to prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for our world and its nations, especially maybe for those who are suffering through the wildfires in Hawaii and other parts of our world, that help and assistance may come quickly. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith. Inspired by the lives of the saints, we may forever try to listen to that call to allegiance to holiness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for those who are sick in mind and body, for those awaiting medical procedures and those recovering from. May they find healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur at this time, the families who grieve and mourn, that they may be comforted. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we ask for the prayers of heaven. Queen of heavens, we pray to heaven.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed are thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death.
Amen.
We make these in all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Which earth has given and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual dream.
Yes, I think about forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord, who in your saints have given an example, who brought us protection in our weakness, to help us tread the path of salvation, mercifully grants that we who honour the heavenly birthday of Blessed St. Clare may, through her example, make our way to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, we
pray,
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original homes, and to bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in a new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we adore.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you with all the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Clare, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Say to the man who informed by divine teaching, who dares to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of my God, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, in commemoration of Blessed St. Clare, sanctify our minds and hearts, that we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature. Through Christ.